I am very excited to talk to you about the ballast fluid. When you're buying a tractor, you want to make sure that it can perform to the optimal. And so I have the Kubota MX 5400, and I want to show you what ballast fluid we chose and how we went about filling this ballast fluid. So first of all, what is ballast fluid? Well, it's the fluid that is put in the tires of a tractor to give it more traction, to give the tractor more balance. It lowers the center of gravity, increases traction, and it provides a counterbalance for the bucket loader and other accessories. Now, this is I look at it as a must in the tractor, as a safety, for the safety of the operation, because if you don't have enough counterbalance, it's very easy to tip, especially if you're going on the hill or if you're lifting heavy things with your tractor, it's very easy to tip. So you want to make sure that your tractor is safe and can operate to the best performance. And so we're going to show you how we went about filling this the tires with ballast fluid. If you want to maximize performance, ensure safety by making sure your tractor doesn't tip over, you need ballast fluid. So water can be used as ballast. However, there are problems with it. First, expansion during freezing can separate the tire from the rim, and second, there are heavier liquids that provide better traction. Let's talk about antifreeze. It is a good option. It's logical alternative. It is pet safe, it's non-toxic, propylene glycol, and it's inexpensive, and it's heavier than water. Okay, how about calcium chloride? Calcium chloride, it's about 40% heavier than water. It's very cheap. However, it can lead to rust or corrosion, so there's a better alternative. Next, let's talk about windshield washer fluid. It's inexpensive, it resists freezing temperatures. However, it weighs about the same as water. So there are better alternatives. Given the disadvantages of other forms of tractor ballast, it may be worth to consider beet juice. Beet juice is non-toxic liquid, and it's about 30% heavier than water, and its freezing point is about negative 35 degrees Fahrenheit. Next, polyurethane foam goes into a tire's liquid, but then it hardens, and then the big attraction of this is that it increases the weight by 50% compared to water. Filling the tractor with the polyurethane foam gives you a non-flat tire, but the future tire adjustments, pressure adjustments, cannot be done. And when you have to change the tire, you have to just cut it off. So beet juice is an amazing option, and that's what our dealer, Kubota dealer, recommended, and that's when we asked for it. We pretty much paid up front for the tractor for the service to be done. So stay tuned to the end of the video to see how it's being done by a professional.
My name is Patrick, I'm from American Tire. I came here to put 55 gallons in each tire, so that way he has some weight in the back, because a lot of times when he's working the machine and he's picking up stuff or hauling dirt, a lot of times there's not enough weight in the back. That's so, you know, there might be some spilling out a little bit on the floor from the tire from the guy, but it's okay because it's beet juice. It doesn't do anything to the ground or nothing.
What fluid is it? Like, what is it exactly?
Beet juice.
Beet?
Like, you know, sugar beets?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's a juice.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's why it's dark. You can tell. You can tell it's dark.
So it's good for the tire. It's not going to ruin the tire, right?
And it doesn't rust your wheel out.
Oh, okay.
Calcium, on the other hand, will eat your tire over time, or the wheel. So when you decide to change tires, the rust will make it very difficult for it to come out.
Where do you guys buy this beet juice? At the sugar factory, or?
Sugar factory, depends who has some. Get in a lot of places.
Looks like we're letting the air out, taking the whole.
To pull out your stem, where your air goes, the trigger goes in here. So this, the stem, this nozzle goes on, but it's gonna go around this, on your stem, like just like so. So you're gonna have a little bit of a spill at times, but this, I'm gonna pull back. So the juice is gonna pump through there into the pump, out this into there. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's make sure you're not. Good suction?
Yeah.
That is some good part.
So you close that up so it locks the juice in there, huh?
The air? And the core I showed you, I have to lock that in there.
Okay.
Give it a few minutes, because if not, if I take it off, it's going to blow up and juice is going to go everywhere. Not that it's going to damage anything, but you don't want to smell like this stuff.
Yeah.
See? I could already tell if it's locked in, so I can try to move it. See that? That's all the air that's being released. Better to come out than just build up. Now, moment of truth. There you go.
Wow, very nice.
Do you remember where I put it?
Yeah.
Where I had the stem?
Yeah, the stem was right there.
Yeah. I'm gonna look where it's at.
Okay, so that's what. It's the stem, man. And that's the adapter.
Yep. You see where it's at now?
Yeah.
Okay. It's ready to get air.
That is so awesome. So
crazy, huh?
Yeah. Stem went in here, and with this little thing over here, we're able to tighten it.
See? And that's how you let the juice in. So once, if this is closed, like the way you have it like that, it's going to clog the machine.
Okay.
That's why you have to pull out like a shot.
Oh, pull it out, let the thing.
And that's where all the juice comes into the tire.
Okay. And then you close it up. Okay, that's awesome. And there's just this adapter for the hose.
Okay, so that's
it.
That's already in there good. That's really good. So now what we're going to do is this one. Whatever's in there, I'm just gonna suck it out over there. Again, it's just beet juice, it's not gonna hurt anything.
Okay.
I mean, are you planning to burn that anyways?
Yeah.
Okay. I want all the air and everything and the gunk out of that, because I don't want none of that going into this tire, because that's what causes the machine to slow down. That's why you saw me switch the hoses, because when the beet juice is so thick and it goes through the machine, it starts to clog it. So this is the whole point of doing this. And when you get clear to the bottom like you just did, you're putting in gunk, which is the beet juice, but it's so thick. Kind of like blood. You want it out.
You want to flush it all.
Yes.
So that's what we're doing. We're flushing the hoses.
I mean, that's fine, but it's too gunk. I want the clear one that's coming in for your other tire. We haven't done anything like this since summer. It's very rare we do it in the winter because there's not a lot of tractor work in the winter.
Oh, I see. That thing went poof. Oh, that thing came off. Is that okay?
No.
So when you let the air out of the tire, it popped out over here, so we had to put liquid soap and pump it back up a little. Did a couple of times. So we'll see what happens now. No.
The bead.
No, nothing's on there.
Perfect.
Whole bunch coming out over here.
That's a good thing. It's trying to keep up. From here and out down to here. That's how fast it's pumping. It's trying to keep up with the tire.
And the goal was to put a barrel in each tire to rear so we could have some weight in the back so that we could be stable. I had issues with this tire because it kept coming off the bead, kept sucking in. So if that's the case, there's no way we're going to be able to put the liquid in here. It is bead juice. So this tire was a cinch. It was a little thicker than this one, but worked out just fine. Besides the weather and the mud, everything went as according to plan, and like I said, this was the only one that gave me a little bit of an issue, but we got it fixed quick. So.
How did you make sure that it doesn't pop back?
I used the air that was pumping from the pump itself to expand the tire from the inside out. So that way, because it needs air to push out the liquid into the tire. So I was trying to catch it, and if I caught it on time, it took me a couple attempts. But the third time I caught it to where I was able to push the air in and it expanded the tire out, which allowed the tire to stay on the bead while getting filled.
Okay.
That was the tricky part.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.